Aluminum presents unique challenges in the metal fabrication industry, most typically clogging or glazing your abrasive. We're joined today by Walter Surface Technologies, who have been experts in high-performance abrasive products since 1952. Like PushCorp, they have built a business around finishing and were the first to introduce 4.5 and 7-inch angle grinders for manual material removal projects. Today, we'll be showcasing some of their products on automated aluminum grinding, cutoff, deburring, and weld cleaning operations. In this video, we will talk through the PushCorp equipment used, some programming tips, and discuss Walter's unique aluminum products that were used and their benefits. All the applications we'll explore use the same PushCorp compliance device and spindle, showcasing their dynamic versatility. The PushCorp AFD310 is an active compliance device that can apply up to 60 pounds of force in any orientation automatically. Its 20 millimeters of compliance stroke allows the media to be applied in a consistent manner and simplifies programming the robot path. The stroke adjusts to slight variations in the part and keeps constant contact as the media wears. The PushCorp STC1503 BT30 spindle boasts a max RPM of 15,000, 3 horsepower, and automatic tool changing. The high RPM was very useful with some of the smaller abrasives and cutters we used. Its constant RPM complements the constant force of the compliance device to give you repeatable results with a robot. PushCorp end effectors are at their best with a premium abrasive on the end. Ryan, thanks for joining us in the lab today to talk through these applications and Walter's aluminum products.
Thanks for having me, Isaiah. I'm excited to be here and to talk through some of the automation opportunities that exist for all of our customers with currently manual aluminum metalworking applications or those who are doing it robotically and want to take it up to the next level.
Great, let's get started. The first application we'll tackle is grinding welds. We demonstrated grinding down to the parent material on both an engine block weld repair and a weld seam on an aluminum ramp. To discuss the abrasives in this video, let's throw it over to Ryan.
Thanks, Isaiah. So bonded and coated abrasives have a bad habit of clogging or glazing when working in soft metals like aluminum. But the Alu or aluminum series from Walter is designed specifically to avoid this phenomenon. So in this first application, we use the Enduroflex Alu, a type 27 flap disc designed specifically for aluminum grinding. The Enduroflex Alu has Walter's exclusive eco-trim backing material and a special stearate coating on the flaps to prevent the abrasive grain blend from clogging, making it by far the longest lasting and most productive flap disc in aluminum. Now, a flap disc is a great option when surface condition is important. It has the right mix of aggressive material removal and flexibility to contour the surfaces without gouging the parent material. But for even more aggressive material removal, the Alu or aluminum grinding wheel is Walter's grinding wheel of choice for aluminum to provide the highest removal rate and longest life in aluminum and other non-ferrous metals when talking about bonded abrasives. We'll talk about the why and the how in just a little bit.
When automating weld grinding operations, unit pressure works in your favor. Initially, all the force is concentrated on the weld. As you grind down to the parent material, that force spreads out over a larger area. This helps you to blend without overgrinding your part. Cutoff operations can be dirty, dull, and dangerous for manual operators. Next, we'll explore automating cutoff operations on aluminum extrusion. The specialized wheel we chose for this process is another product in Walter's Alu line. Could you tell us a little more, Ryan?
Absolutely. So the Zip Alu is Walter's cutting wheel of choice in aluminum, from thin gauge exterior siding to aluminum extrusions, even up to thicker cast aluminum parts, degating and deflashing. The Zip Alu provides the longest life and fastest cutting speed in non-ferrous metals. We use a similar grain and additive composition to our aluminum grinding wheel, where we've integrated paraffins into the abrasive mix to help lubricate the wheel in a way that prevents aluminum particles from clogging naturally porous bonded abrasive wheels. This ensures that the wheels continue to wear at proper speeds and always exposes fresh abrasive grain for faster cuts and maximized cuts per wheel.
The same equipment setup that allows you to perform the cutoff operation can perform an automatic tool change to a deburring setup. This PushCorp spindle utilizes a standard BT30 taper tool holder, enabling you to make tool swaps similar to a CNC. More on the deburring operation up next. Many aluminum parts just like these have some sort of deburring requirement. Possibly deburring a part after cutting it to size, or after a secondary machining process to mill slots or other holes. Whether in new production or repair operations, deburring hard to reach cavities or edges is common in cast parts. Ryan, what options does Walter have for these types of processes?
So Walter's variety of tools and solutions extend far beyond just abrasives, and this is a perfect example. Walter's Blendex HD finishing drum is designed to maximize life and provide the most consistent performance in demanding applications like deburring corners and sharp edges. This denser, non-woven composition with a proprietary polyurethane filling material allows the Blendex HD drum to have greater rigidity and longer life when working on sharp edges, while also providing an impeccable surface finish. Alternatively to abrasives, Walter offers a complete line of made in the USA carbide burrs under our Drillco brand. Now, aluminum or non-ferrous cut burrs are designed specifically for extended life in aluminum. With deeper flutes, less cutting edges, and larger spacing between the cutting edges, aluminum and non-ferrous burrs cut longer chips in softer metals like aluminum versus small chips created by typical double cut burrs. This helps eliminate the sticking or clogging of aluminum in the flutes and ensures that the deburring operation never gets slowed down by a clogged cutting tool.
When using a finishing drum to deburr, be sure to use the full face of the drum, ideally in a slightly diagonal motion to ensure even wear of the drum face. When using a carbide burr to deburr or remove material, be sure to operate the cutting tool at the highest possible surface feet per minute or RPM of the machine, all the while respecting the safety guidelines of the manufacturer. These types of tools are built to turn at high speeds and provide the most consistent results in material removal behavior at the fastest possible speed. When performing surface cleaning operations, there's often a need to remove the contaminants on the surface while not affecting the parent material. We're demonstrating two weld cleaning processes reaching the welds in these two 90-degree corners. Let's get the breakdown on the consumable media.
So at Walter, we have two distinct types of wire wheels based on the material you're working on, and they're very easy to differentiate between. For working on aluminum, we use Walter's blue hubbed wire wheels, which are made with wires of 304 stainless steel. It's guaranteed not to contaminate any material being worked on. If you used carbon steel wires working on stainless steel or aluminum, it's possible that iron particles can be introduced to the parent material, which can eventually lead to corrosion or staining, etc. So when working on stainless steel and aluminum applications, always use Walter's blue hubbed Walter wire wheels. Now, best practice when working with wire wheels is to always let the tips of the wire do the work, and adjust the position of the robot arm whenever possible to ensure the optimal working angle. Walter offers a variety of sizes and shapes to help you choose the best shaped Walter wire brush product for your application. Now, common uses of wire brush in automated settings could include cleaning weld passes during multi-pass welding operations, or removing paint, rust, and other discoloration from metal surfaces. Now, from a finishing abrasives perspective, where the final product's surface will either show the weld or maybe head to paint right after the weld cleaning operation, we have our FX stainless wheel. Now, the FX stainless is an excellent alternative to pickling paste for weld cleaning in stainless steel and for cleaning up aluminum welds. In no time, the FX stainless removes any weld discoloration or surface contaminants and will provide a beautiful, polished, and brushed sanitary finish. The open structure of the wheel provides great flexibility to work on parts of all shapes and sizes and extend service life by preventing any loading from the wheel or clogging with dust or soft metals. You can run it individually or even stack them to a side if you want to hug a weld seam. It gives a beautiful polished finish.
When using wheels that wear, PushCorp's servo motor is able to speed up to maintain your surface feet per minute. This ensures the same cut through the life of the wheel, giving you repeatable and consistent results. In both cases of FX stainless and wire brushes from Walter, it's recommended to look for the optimal RPM or surface feet per minute that will allow the wheels to work without losing their shape. In the cases of these types of media, max RPM is not always equal to optimal RPM. We'd like to extend a big thank you to Walter for visiting our lab today. If you'd like to have a conversation about automating your material removal application, please send an email to sales@pushcorp.com. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you next time.